Welcome back. Halftime in Washington, D.C. Duke 34, West Virginia 29. Greg Bobertag back along with Bob Wenzel. By the way, the Blue Devils 24-2 during the season, Bob, when they lead at the break. The difference in the first 20 minutes from what we saw Thursday in round one, that on the belt buckle defense we talked about, yeah, it's pretty tough right now. Duke has really stepped it up from what we saw two nights ago against Belmont.
Well, West Virginia's 0 for 5 from downtown. Duke has only made 2. We told you at the beginning of the game how Duke's three-point shooting is very important to them. To win, if they're not shooting well from three-point range, they have to do something dramatic somewhere else, and they've done it defensively. They have taken Alexander out of the game very, very nicely. They're challenging shots and forcing the drive. They're doing a great job with their scouting report on being up on shooters. As I mentioned, West Virginia made 5 threes in the first half against Arizona. Zippo in this one.
And here's the in-game box score powered by CBS College Sports Network, the 24-hour college sports channel from CBS Sports. Alexander, 11 points, Bob, 5 of 13 shooting. He's earned every bucket along the way. And Greg Polis, remember, the quick start for Duke really helped the tempo for the Blue Devils, dropping down 2 early three-pointers.
And those are the only 2 that have been made in the game by either team. Polis and Duke are 2 for 9. Joe Alexander and his teammates 0 for 5 so far from three-point range. Good D by both teams. What is the antidote for West Virginia to get back in it? Well, Butler's back in the game after 2 early fouls. That will help them on the offensive boards.
And Bob, somebody's season ends tonight or this afternoon in Washington. Henderson, exclamation point. Henderson, the hero. Against Belmont, starts the half with the slam and a look. Did you see the look?
Great play coming out of the half. The setup.
Butler flips it out front to Smith. That ball is nearly taken away. Everybody on the deck fighting for it. Duke clears. Nelson, it's 2-on-2. Blue Devils trying to put this game on ice early. No. And the rebound to West Virginia. Lewis Nichols. Couple of bounces across the timeline. And the intensity has not given up since we went to the halftime. Nichols.
Nichols can take Singler off the dribble.
Oh, that's a great crossover. Takes it up high, overshoots the hoop. That ball is loose. And out of the pack comes Paulus. 8 points in the first half. Paulus works his way to the front court. Winding up from the corner. No. Well, DeMarcus Nelson, averaging 15 points a ball game, has struggled thus far here in Washington. Dropped down a couple of hoops in the first half. And West Virginia fans, Bob, you can kind of feel that little edge beginning to settle in. A little edgy.
Struggling at this end the entire game. Denial defense of Duke has been great. Switching has been effective.
Smith looks inside. The ball is caught. Ruoff. Dropped it out of bounds. Good D by Nelson out front. Nichols puts it on the floor. Back down Smith. Shot clock winds out, and it's done.
You talk about good defense? There was 35 seconds of it. Huggins not happy, of course, that his team did not get a shot off. Credit Duke. Looks like they got 7 guys out there right now.
Well, West Virginia's backcourt struggling. Nichols and Ruoff a combined 2 of 7. In the first half, and they were the energizers in that win against Arizona on Thursday night, Bob. So far, they've been clamped down tight.
Exactly, and they were 9 of 14 from three-point land in that game. That was the difference that caused the separation against Arizona. Not so today.
Smith with 2 fouls. Out front, that ball's loose. Nelson now on the drive. Little push shot. Backside rebound cleared. Beautifully done. Paulus. Boy, Duke is so crisp. Henderson backs it out with 30 on the shot clock. Paulus the dribble on the wing. Thomas tries to clear through. And now Nelson stops and goes. West Virginia trying to shut down that passing lane as well. Henderson nearly lost it. Picks it up. Flies a jump shot short. Inside and a foul. Boy, Duke is everywhere.
Duke Singler had only 3 offensive rebounds, Craig, in the first half, and they have got 2 in the early moments here. West Virginia's defense was very good for 2 possessions here, but Duke got offensive rebounds and an opportunity right here to score. That takes a lot out of you when you go 35 and another 35. And of course, Wellington Smith, one of the better interior guys for West Virginia, picks up his third.
And the perfect free throw shooting continues. Duke now 13 of 13, 12 for 12 in the first half. Well, you know, three fouls. Pardon me, Bob. Wellington Smith goes to the bench, and he'll have to ride the pine a while as Mazzulla, who was a nice spark plug for Bob Huggins, checks in.
Yeah, and he's been very, very good in crucial games this year. So often teams lament their free throw woes after a loss in the NCAA tournament. You can also praise your high percentage when you get a W.
First miss by Duke at the line. Mazzulla lobs it up over the top. Alexander, good look, and the offensive rebound of the putback. I'll tell you what, Alexander better shake Butler's hand. Thank you very much, because Joe had a dead-on look.
The Butler helped him, huh? I'll tell you what, the two of them are very, very good on the offensive board. The fact that Butler only played 11 minutes in the first half is very, very important indeed for Bob Huggins. He's got to keep him in here the whole time.
Off the hands of Ruoff. Yeah, Butler and Alexander have combined for 19 of the 31 West Virginia points. And Bob, again, if West Virginia is going to pull off this win, I think you've got to get help. You've got to get an outside shot or two from Nichols or Ruoff.
Indeed.
Clear out Nelson behind the three-point line, wide open. That's an air ball.
Whoa!
Air ball off the hand of Henderson. That starts the break. Mazzulla gets it up. West Virginia needs a three, and they got it.
That's what you were talking about, my friend.
First three-point shot by the Mountaineers today. And the crowd erupts in response.
Nichols has played more games than any player in the history of West Virginia University. And no finer time than this for Mr. Darris Nichols. On the break, Mazzulla the pass, Nichols bottom, West Virginia's back.
Duke with a three-point lead on West Virginia, but Darris Nichols trying to work the Mountaineers back. The emotion is definitely back in this building after the three ball dropped by Nichols.
Butler and Alexander doing it for West Virginia right now. The significance of Butler for their team is so vital on the offensive boards. Alexander needs a partner in the post.
Paulus takes the inbound. 15:50 to play. The winner moves on to the Sweet 16. Nelson rolls in, double team, wraps it around his back and turned it over. Well, you saw that pivot foot just kind of stop, and then he picked it up. Turnover Duke.
He's not getting by people. Most teams that scout well understand Nelson's best attribute is getting it all the way to the basket. They're playing him soft and moving with him as he gets to the paint.
Nelson 2 of 9 shooting so far this ball game, and the ninth turnover committed by the Blue Devils. And on the wing is Nichols, feeds Alexander. Well, look how quick Duke collapses on the big fella. That ball is batted out. Mazzulla chases it down.
12th offensive rebound.
Mazzulla wraps it behind his back. Leaves it. Oh, that's a tough pass. The catch, the shoot.
Oh! As the shot clock went down! Ruoff! Oh, took the roof goodness. Off!
Are you joking or what?
Henderson battles inside, a whistle. And we're tied at 37 on a circus shot as the buzzer. As the shot clock went out.
Ruoff, your teammates love you. You're sitting on the bench after this free throw because that's how far away you were. Academic All-American and trick shot artist.
37 all, the foul whistled on Alexander, and only the second miss by Duke. From the line,
the two teams are now even in threes made in the game, and Bob, both teams have two.
Bob, we take you back. Let's go back Thursday night and talk about Duke rattled right now, because they were rattled when Belmont answered with threes time and time again.
And Belmont did what Darris Nichols did. They shot early in transition in the three-point situation. When you go against Duke's half-court defense from the three-point line and in, they are murder. Very, very difficult to score against them. But shoot early, that's the antidote.
Alexander scoops it up and in. Count it, and a foul shot to come. Ball has the emotion in this building flip-flop.
This is great execution. The curl play. Missoula, it was a bounce pass. Much more accurate than an air pass. The rest is athleticism. Very well designed.
Whistle on Henderson, his second. West Virginia's first lead, Bob, since 4-3 early in the first half. Alexander, 14-point game.
Duke is an experienced team with a great coach. How will they respond to this kind of change in direction of the game?
Polish drives baseline, nothing there. Shire out front. Oh, that's a tough pass as he bounced it off the floor and over the back pole.
Butler is waving to Bob Huggins. He does not want to come out of the game. He didn't need denial that far out. Singler was far enough where he could have played behind him.
And Bob Huggins is going to keep Deshaun Butler in with the three fouls. 8 points on the game. Henderson drives, hangs it up high, and a whistle.
When Duke is in doubt in the two games in Washington, they have gone to Henderson. A good way to stop momentum is get to the free throw line or get fouls. They've drawn two in the last 6 seconds.
And the foul before the shot, Nichols with his second. Duke pushing Smith high off the window, and another foul offensive on a push. And that will be on Singler, and Bob, that's three on Kyle Singler.
The drive, Singler pushes clearly Butler under the basket.
West Virginia by two, trailed by five at the break. Nichols out front. Drive, stops on a pivot, hangs it out front. Ruoff in traffic.
Offensive foul.
Nobody wants to go home.
Ruoff his third.
This is physical. Terrific play by Shire. That's exactly what you want to do. Ruoff got court standing straight up. He was trying to clear some space.
Under 14 minutes to play. Bob, you're right. Nobody wants to go home. And what a play on into April. Singler puts it on the floor, drives it up. Oh, that ball is stripped. Alexander got a piece. West Virginia on the run. Ruoff in transition. No! One official pointed to West Virginia. The other now switches off, and it's going to be Duke basketball.
Right here, the terrific block by Alexander. Talking a little bit. Singler thought he had a layup. And a good play at the other end also by Duke. I think the halftime speeches of these two coaches were pretty good. Intensity level is through the roof.
Fire and brimstone.
Amen.
Pull-up jumper. Oh, sweet. Down she goes, Shire. Double figures for the sophomore from Northbrook, Illinois. 10 points to lead Duke. We're tied at 40. We run up on 13 minutes to play. Phoenix awaits the winner, the Sweet 16. Alexander, three ball on the way. Looks good. Yes!
He's not thinking anymore. In the first half, his reactions were slow. Now he's just reacting to the flow of the game.
17 for Alexander. And a swat on the other end. Back-to-back blocks on the defensive end for Alexander. Three swats on the day. And over the back, the foul. Singler picks up number four.
How about Alexander? Catch it and shoot. The more you think, the slower you play. And at this end, athleticism by the preeminent forward in the Big East.
Bob, the story developing here, West Virginia's three-point shooting. 0 for 6, first half, 3 for 3 here in the first 7.5 minutes of half number two.
Big time difference.
Another whistle on the rebound.
Foul trouble may decide this game.
Butler, who begged Bob Huggins to stay on the court, picks up number four.
So Singler and Butler both with four right here. Key players for their team. Both go to the bench. So who is deeper? Take a look at these foul situations. Ruoff and Smith also with three. Duke fairly okay other than Singler. Singler is their best interior player. Lance Thomas is going to have to take his place.
Free throw comes off the rim, and West Virginia, led by Mazzulla, brings it into front court. Wellington Smith with three fouls, replaces Butler with four. Alexander gave up the jump shot. Nichols behind the three-point line, behind his back. Oh, that tenacious defense of Duke. Continues to push out behind the arc. That shot is short. Ruoff follows. Oh, banked it.
Tough, tough shot.
21 points against Arizona. And he's dropped down 7-5 here in the second half for West Virginia. And a foul, offensive foul, called on Duke. Lance Thomas whistled for his second.
Ruoff's shot was unbelievably tough. Watch this. He misses this shot, follows his own because he's not blocked out, knocks it off the backboard. That's a great horse shot. 26 double-figure games coming into the tournament for Alex.
Question is, did he call it bank?
The defense is not there like it was in the first half for the Blue Devils.
Timeout, Mike Krzyzewski. West Virginia 7-13 from the floor in the second half. And they've opened up a 7-point lead on CBS. West Virginia trailing by 5 at the break, now own a 7-point lead. How do you come back? Well, you do it first with defense and second with three-pointers.
Joe Alexander, two consecutive blocks. Alex Ruoff, a circus three. And then Alexander also from three-point range off a quick screen, quick hitter. And they are right back in the game and have the lead. And
Bob, an 18-6 run here in the second half. 11:43 to play. And another reminder, this is for a trip to Phoenix in the Sweet 16.
West Virginia started 0-for-6 from three-point range, 3-of-4 since then, just the opposite for Duke. 2-for-3 to start the game by Paulus, since zip-for-8 for Duke from downtown.
So Henderson set to inbound for Duke.
Tradition comes into play here. Don't be surprised if Duke has a big run to get themselves right back in right away.
They've made runs throughout the season. They're 28-5. West Virginia 25-10. Henderson, little bump by Smith, backs it out. 11:30 to play. Runs around. Ruoff kick out McClure. Shire wants that ball instead. Finds Paulus wide open for three. That ball is wide left to Smith. Wellington Smith the rebound, and West Virginia with a 7-point lead and the basketball.
Craig, West Virginia went matchup zone right there for the first time in the game. Confused Duke.
Mazzulla's had a terrific tournament thus far. Offensive foul. Smith picks up number four and a timeout. West Virginia by 7. Back in Washington, West Virginia 47, Duke 40. You look at the bracket here, West Virginia, Duke. Of course, the winner moves on to Phoenix. And later this afternoon, Purdue Xavier will battle for that trip to the Southwest. After the timeout, Mike Krzyzewski broke the huddle quickly, and the five on the floor have been huddled up themselves talking about, can we work this comeback? Second seed of the West against number 7.
They need some intestinal fortitude right now. West Virginia showed it coming from behind. And let's see what kind of response we get from Duke.
Paulus out front, guarded by Mazzulla.
drew off on Henderson. He is the likely guy to go here.
Alexander all over. Paulus hands it off. LeClaire gives it back. Paulus deep three. Short. Ball's loose. Alexander has it. West Virginia now, Bob, extending their defense out, forcing Duke to take not just threes, long threes.
Yeah, and it was sort of a funky defense. Some switching man-to-man way out high. Boy, is it physical away from the ball.
Oh, there's a steal. LeClaire looks inside, hands it off. On the low block, Henderson clears it away. 25 on the shot clock. LeClaire in the corner, bodies are down, and a whistle. Well, fouls, Bob, you called it, down the stretch run. How is this going to play out? Butler, Smith with four. Ruoff with three for West Virginia. Singler with four. Henderson and Thomas with two apiece.
Well, Butler, when he got his third, waved off Bob Huggins. Bob wanted to take him out right then. Then he picked up his foul, stayed in. The two most significant guys on that list are Singler and Butler.
Under 10 minutes to play. Alexander against Thomas. Puts the ball on the floor. Double pumps. Hangs on a pivot. Boy, clears that out with 13 on the shot clock. Alexander, tough shot, falling away, airballed it. And Duke has it. Alexander in this ball game, Bob. Shooting has been difficult. 7 of 19. Yet still able to drop down 17 points.
I'll tell you, he is a scoring machine. Had 30 in three of his last six games coming in to the NCAA.
Duke fans on their feet. Trying to be the sixth man for the Blue Devils. Shire drives, hangs it up high, rolls it in, count it, and a foul shot.
Well, since West Virginia made their run, the game has been stalled out. Nobody's scoring until this point. Shire doesn't look strong, but he's got some wiry strength to him. Terrific balance on that one.
Alexander picks up his third personal. Shire to the line. Was on a roll in the first half from the free throw line.
Had 13 against Arizona.
And 13 against West Virginia. A four-point ball game. West Virginia with the basketball and the lead. Ruoff right in front of Bob Huggins. Nichols on the wing. Alexander pops out with 17 on the shot clock. Feeds down low. On a rope, baby. On a rope to Ruoff. Wow.
Backdoor Page out of Rick Bird and Belmont. That was so successful against Duke on Thursday.
Henderson tied up, able to get that ball away, and then a whistle baseline.
When you are overplayed, you set up the back door, and right here, watch Ruoff fake, cut, and wide open. Shire was staring at the ball, didn't see his man.
First assist and a big one for Joe Alexander. And Nelson now at the line, struggling this afternoon. 4 points on 3 of 16 shooting.
Only had two against Belmont.
Well, near the end of today's game, we'll select a Chevrolet player of the game from each team. And to honor their determination and outstanding play, Chevrolet will make a $1,000 contribution to each university's general scholarship fund. At Chevy, an American Revolution. One more for Nelson. Makes 1 of 2. First point for Nelson here in the second half. Bob, you have to like the way that Missoula's come off the bench and provided some strong minutes.
I love this kid. You talk about one tough customer. Missoula's been a sixth man in the backcourt, playing virtually the whole game here today because Bob Huggins has decided to go small. Missoula and Nichols are the guards, and Ruoff, normally the two guard, is playing three spot in this game. Duke has more trouble against small teams than they do against big teams.
Alexander's shot rims out. A rebound, baseline, and a foul.
Missoula again, right involved in the action.
Two quick fouls now against DeMarcus Nelson as Mike Krzyzewski battling the flu, looks on. He may be feeling a little sick right now with 8:36 to play and looking at a 5-point deficit.
Three fouls on DeMarcus Mazzulla. Smallest guy on the floor goes to the offensive board.
Mazzulla, 7 points, seven rebounds.
Johnstown, Rhode Island, only a sophomore. His teammates love him.
And Bob, he can play the one or the two guard.
Yeah, and he can guard guys 6'8" also. Don't be surprised if you see him guarding somebody in the post in this game.
Eight off the bench for Mazzulla. Seven rebounds, six assists. Well, that's a complete game. Duke trying to roar back. Oh, that's a great shot. Baseline, Henderson.
That's the guy who was the hero against Belmont. He is the likely candidate to take this game over for Duke.
51-46, 8:20 to play. Alexander on the wing. Tries to go one-on-one with Thomas, and then a whistle tied up in the paint. And Thomas will pick up foul number three. You Bob, plenty of whistles, in this game.
You want to see some quickness? Wow, what a first step. And the easy finish. Boy, does Gerald have some athletic ability, huh, Craig? Wow.
Alexander at the free throw line, 17 points. Boy, the fouls. Singler with four, Thomas three, Nelson three for Duke. Deshaun Butler with four, Alexander and Ruoff with three.
And that begs the question, when do you bring in a key player when he's got four fouls? It depends on where you are in the game. Singler and Butler. When will Krzyzewski and Huggins bring them back into this contest? I'm guessing around the 6-minute mark. If you have the lead, you can wait longer. If you're behind, you got to come sooner.
Three for three from the line. And the first miss. Oh, West Virginia grabs the rebound and a fresh 35 as we head up onto 8 minutes to play. Mazzulla. And the rebound backside Shire. And the sophomore runs it across midcourt. Oh, Thomas put the hit on Mazzulla. That's four on Lance Thomas. And Mazzulla is still down. 7:51 to play. 52-46. It's rough in Washington. 7:51 to play, 52-46 West Virginia. The Mountaineers shooting 40%. Bob, look at the combined three-point shooting. 5 of 23 in this game. Turnovers, both in double digits, but it's been physical. And let's go early where Wellington Smith has said hello to one Greg Paulus.
It is dangerous on the perimeter for the point guards. That was the first half. This was moments ago. Paulus goes down, Mazzulla goes down. And I'll tell you what, when you try to guard a guy closely, you're going to get whacked out here. The reason that Mazzulla can stay in the game, a timeout was called. If he had been attended to, he would have had to sit out momentarily, and they certainly don't want that. Fouls, Butler and Singler, most vital guys.
Lance Thomas out after that foul with four. And a quick dump down into Alexander. Not prepared for it. In fact, he's talking.
Well, Thurman
on the way back up court.
Yeah, Thurman is a guy who is not used a lot, but because of the foul trouble, he's getting opportunity in the biggest game of the year for West Virginia.
Henderson tries to slide, slips it out. Nelson, good look for three. Ricochets off the rim, and Mazzulla right there. He picked himself off the floor and got a rebound. That's eight boards for Mazzulla.
Boy, is that a tough guy. Eight rebounds for the smallest player on the floor. A lot to admire in Mazzulla.
Alexander, boy, draws a crowd wherever he goes.
And that crowd was a little too much because he got fouled. Singler back in the game. We felt that he would come in about the 6-minute mark. Mike Krzyzewski feels he's got to be in now. Without Singler, they have a very difficult time scoring around the basket.
Shire whistled for his second foul. And Alexander to the free throw line. 3 of 4 this afternoon.
What a player. He documented his early childhood, brought up in the Far East.
Well, Alexander makes the first. You look at stories around the tournament. Bob, Big East 7-1, the Big 12 5-1, Pac-10 500 basketball. Top three seeds are combined 12-0.
What a shock.
How about the debuts for Beasley and Rose?
I'll tell you what, Beasley is something at your alma mater. He is a basketball genius. Uncanny ability to rebound.
20-point game for Alexander. 54-46. Shire deep. Alexander reaches out, pulls down the rebound. The threes will not drop in the second half for Duke.
And nobody on the offensive boards. If they're not making threes, they've got to be dramatic somewhere else. And they were in the first half on D, but not this time.
Well, Henderson really playing tough defense on Alexander. Calls timeout. West Virginia will talk about it with 6:37 to play. Mountaineers 54, the Blue Devils 46 on CBS.
Oh.
54-46, and Bob, the second half, very little has gone right for Duke.
I'll tell you what, we were praising the Blue Devils defense in the first half. We got to give high marks to the Mountaineers as well. Duke has only scored 12 points in the second half, and the Mountaineers came out of the locker room with intensity and fire in their eyes, and they have performed admirably.
Alexander catches the ball, no, lost it. Henderson loved his kid's play. He's everywhere, lost it out of bounds. But, coach, as a coach, you love that kind of effort.
Absolutely. Look at this. Acceleration, speed. And Henderson uses it not only on offense, but defense as well. He is only a sophomore, superior athlete.
Ed Hightower is at the scorer's table. And they want to look at the clock. It shows 6:34 left.
I think it's a shot clock issue right here. Right here, a few seconds ran off. And there was no possession change. So as a result, it's likely they'll take a few seconds off of the shot clock. Oh, I see what they have. 18 right here on your left-hand side of your screen. That was what was left. I don't think they can change that because possession did not change.
Duke fans up behind the Blue Devil bench trying to inspire a comeback. Bob, as you mentioned, a 12-point second half by Duke. And they're going to reset the shot clock to 15.
Craig, it's getting loud in here.
Oh, the emotions. It's a two seed, don't forget, against a number seven. Duke was pushed to the limit Thursday night by Belmont. 71-70 here. Owned a 5-point lead at the half. Looked to have things in control. But so far, not the case in half number two.
You're going to see some double teaming. Try to get the dribbler out of control if you're Duke, and then make them travel or an inadvertent pass.
Paulus puts up a hand. The shot by Nichols. Off the mark, out of bounds. Duke will have possession with 6:19 to play.
That was really not a bad shot. It may have looked that way, but there was only four ticks left. That was a shot clock shot.
And Bob, to document Duke's woes in the second half, only 4 of 16 shooting from the floor.
Credit the defense of the Mountaineers. They played well.
Paulus deep. 4 of 17. And out of the pack comes Mazzulla.
Notice where that shot missed. 0 for their last 13 threes. Front rim. What does that tell you?
Tired legs.
Amen.
Tired legs. Mazzulla. Right to left hand. Down the middle of the paint.
You gotta love this guy. Gets hit and knocked down. Looks like he might not come back into the game. Comes in, takes over with the bounce. He's the backup point guard, not the starter. He and Nichols work very, very well together.
Only a sophomore from Johnston, Rhode Island. And Mazzulla back at the line. He's been the tempo setter here for West Virginia in the second half.
Did you notice that middle stat? 8 rebounds for this young man.
Well, Monday, the madness continues with a hit comedy, The Big Bang Theory. That's Monday at 8, 7 Central, right here on CBS. Now, Krzyzewski makes changes, and back in is Thomas with 4 fouls.
Well, he doesn't want Singler to pick up his fifth foul. So Singler goes to the bench. He wants him in for the last moments of the game.
Mazzulla makes one at two. Duke reaches up for the rebound. Nelson between his legs and a whistle.
The response right now, Craig, for Duke is take the ball to the basket hard with the dribble, because we've documented what Mike knows also is that they're not making their shots from the outside. If you can score when the clock is stopped, when you're behind in a game, that is the best possible scenario.
Nelson at the line after the second foul on Mazzulla. Nelson with 6 points, and coming up, stay tuned, you'll see Beasley and Kansas State take on Wisconsin. A game is scheduled to tip at 4:20 Eastern right here on CBS. Another full day of college basketball. Stay tuned. Nelson, one more. We're not done here. 5:36 in Washington, D.C. Nelson short that one. Boy, he barely hit the iron.
We're going to see some heart right here from the guys in the white jerseys. You'll see pressure D, denial everywhere. All-out effort and the back door.
The cut.
How about that? Seldom used. Thurman reads the defense perfectly.
And Bob, the assist, Alexander. Duke desperate for buckets. No. And the three ball will not go down. Offensive foul. Or no, they're going to call that on Mazzulla, his third.
Postman to postman, back door. Moving without the ball is Thurman. The pass by Alexander. That is a thing of beauty. That is how to attack when you're being pressured.
So Mazzulla picks up his third. And at the line goes Shire. A 13-point afternoon. 13 in round one against Belmont. Drops down to first. Paulus and Thomas go out. Henderson returns along with Singler. Despite the four fouls, Coach Krzyzewski must use Kyle Singler.
Yeah, interesting, though. He's substituting offense, defense, and he's putting Singler in when Duke is on the defensive end.
15 for Shire. Duke still alive, 57-49.
Bob Huggins does not want to make any changes because he has the lead. He still has Butler on the bench, one of his best guys with four.
Ruoff. Nichols out front. He's got a great three-guard combo right now with Nichols, Ruoff, and Mazzulla.
Yeah, too early to stall, though. You got to keep playing.
Down low, Alexander caught it out front. Ruoff for three. Got it! Oh, how big is that?
Same spot as Thursday night when Arizona was closing. What a stroke.
12 points for Ruoff. 11-point lead, West Virginia. Duke in trouble. Henderson drives and a whistle.
Alex Ruoff, Greg, is one of the best shooters in the land and in the Big East. Watch his follow through. Wave goodbye to the ball, Alex. Perfect form. What a shooter and what a clutch play there.
Ruoff has bounced back. Here in the second half, Bob, 2 points, 1 of 4 in the first 20 minutes. He's dropped down 10 in the second half.
Wow, what a difference.
And that includes a pair of three-point shots.
And one from their bench, which was circus. Henderson's the guy, really, for Duke. He can create his own shot. He can get fouled very easily. Nobody can stay with him on West Virginia's team. He needs to touch it almost every time.
Double figures for Gerald Henderson, 10 points. Threw down 21 and drove in for the winner to save the day against Belmont on Thursday night.
Looks of concern on the part of the Blue Devils, but 4:23 is an eternity in the NCAA tournament.
And Bob, you make the point. You score when the clock is stopped, and they just picked up two.
That's exactly how you have to do it, and Henderson can get fouled.
Alexander behind the three-point line gives it away to Ruoff. He knows who has the hot hand. Boy, Duke has missed 15 consecutive three-point attempts. Mazzulla lobs it out front. Alexander holds. 4 minutes to play.
Spread the floor, but don't be too careful.
Free throw line jumper off the mark. Rebound. How big was that?
Thurman This substitute's been fabulous.
Blocked! Henderson! Another rebound by Thurlman. Another possession for West Virginia.
Desire. Nobody wants to go home in the NCAA tournament.
Missoula in traffic. Up and in! Thurlman!
He's going to get votes for governor!
62-51. Short all afternoon. West Virginia fans on their feet. Duke timeout, 62-51, West Virginia. Welcome back to Washington, D.C. It's round two of the West region. West Virginia trailed by five at the break. Now own an 11-point advantage over number two-seeded Duke in the West in Missoula. Joe Missoula, part of that tough three-guard lineup that Bob Huggins has gone with here in the second half.
He has been fabulous. 9 rebounds, 9 points, 7 assists. He's breathing on a triple-double, and he's the backup point guard. How about that?
And only one turnover with his tenacious Duke defense. Ruoff went up, and a foul. We'll have a timeout with 3:01 to play. Well, there are two Joes on this West Virginia team. One is Joe Alexander, and Bob, we got to know Joe Missoula today.
Welcome to the big time, Mr. Missoula. You started it off with an assist, and that was their first three. You're rebounding like a 6'10 player, and you're running the show like a point guard, and you're sacrificing your body for the Mountaineers. How about that?
And how about Kansas State and Wisconsin? That's coming up next. 4:20 tip. Eastern time here on CBS, the final 3:01 here in Washington, D.C.
How about this guy? 9 points, 9 rebounds, 7 assists, way above his normal averages of 5 and 3, and on the biggest stage you can possibly imagine.
Ruoff calmly sinks the free throw. 13 for Ruoff. Guard play the difference, Bob, plain and simple, and the fact that Duke could not hit the outside shot. 64-51.
Sorry, Craig. 2 for 18 from downtown.
Desperation. Singler drives into paint, double pump, puts up the shot, and Singler will shoot free throws.
Boy, have they missed him with his 4 fouls. When he went out with 4, that had a lot to do with the change in this game as well.
Alexander whistled for his 4th. That's put Singler at the line. Held to just 5 points in this ball game. What a terrific high school player at South Medford High School. A year ago, he's playing high school hoop, averaging 29 points, nearly 11 rebounds a ball game.
The foul situation has been important in the outcome of this game. Both teams struggled with it. Both coaches had to make decisions about when to put guys in and out. Substitute players have made a big impact on the game, Missoula especially.
And Lance Thomas, as we went to that last commercial break, picked up his 5th, and he's done for the day for Duke. West Virginia breaks the pressure by Duke. Missoula, oh, there's a nice steal by Shire. But again, West Virginia puts on the heavy double team, clears it away into the front court. Henderson, right hand, slides in. Ball is popped out of there like a cork and a whistle.
Henderson gives a shake and goes hard to his right. He's impossible to guard. Right here in the open floor, same basket where he won the game against Belmont. Trying to get his team back in it.
And Bob, Deshaun Butler will go to the bench with his 5th foul. So Duke has lost Lance Thomas. West Virginia loses Deshaun Butler.
Both coaches skillful in negotiating the foul situation for their teams. They maintained intensity. Butler, one of the key players on this team, had 19 in the game against Arizona. and he has been in and out all night, and now he's out for good.
Well, Duke started this game 13 of 13 from the line. Since then, they've hit 10 of their last 15.
Still a pretty good average, but heavy legs in some of those shots. Keep in mind that Duke is a team with great tradition and great pride. Don't be surprised to see a rush here at the end.
And again, the clock is stopped. And Henderson cannot get the free throw. And Monday, the madness continues in an all-new episode of TV's number one comedy, 2 and a Half Men, at 9, 8 Central, right here on CBS. One more for Henderson. Oh, he missed them both.
Man.
Masuda covers up for West Virginia.
That's his 10th rebound, huh?
Incredible off the bench. I'll tell you, this three-guard lineup again on the court most of the second half by Bob Huggins has been, to say the least, impressive.
Very effective.
Ruoff swings it out.
And part of the reason that we, you know, is this guy with the basketball right here. He's had to guard bigger players as Ruoff.
Ruoff drives it in, hangs it high off the glass. The putback, no. One more time, it's loose. And a foul reaching in.
Guess who?
Missoula Shire. Shire picks up number 4, but the little man was looking for another rebound. They're going to give that to Paulus.
How can Missoula get rebounds in the paint with guys 6 inches taller? This guy is incredible.
At the line for West Virginia, number 3, Joe Missoula, shooting 2.
So Paulus the foul. Shire was right there taking a swipe, and Missoula goes into double figures with 10.
10 points, 10 rebounds. 11 rebounds, excuse me.
And 7 assists. Missoula continues to pour it on. 7 points here in the second half. 3.5 shot finally drops as Henderson breaks a long drought by the Blue Devils. 1:54 to play. Duke still with a long way to come back on CBS. Well, Bob, it's a big hill. 1:54 to play. 3-point shooting, when you break this game down, will be the difference maker. Until that last 3-point shot by Henderson, Duke had missed 15 in a row.
And that is one of their big weapons, and it has been missing in their last 3 games. Against Clemson in that loss, 6. And in their game against Belmont, only made 6 as well. So as a result, Duke really, really struggling with their offense.
West Virginia breaks the press. Ruoff gives it up down low. Nichols, they're going to use clock. Well coached.
Craig, West Virginia was picked 10th in the preseason poll in the 16-team Big East. They finished 5th. Surprised everybody. And how about this surprise? You talk about emotional guys getting ready. They are playing their best basketball of the year right now.
Missoula's just taken over this game. And traveled. Takes a glance at the bench in disbelief. And 1:26 remains. West Virginia can punch the ticket to Phoenix in the Sweet 16. Henderson goes baseline. Busted out of bounds. Bob, another player that won't get a lot of ink with this game's over, but Thurlman here in the last 10 minutes has played, I mean, way above what we've seen before.
Oh, he was fabulous in this game. He played well against Connecticut also this year, but I'll tell you what, on this stage, a great, great thing for this man.
Alexander Holes draws a double team and a timeout. Timeout, West Virginia, 1:10 on the clock. We'll be back on CBS. And Bob, time to hand out the Chevrolet Most Valuable Players tonight. Missoula with 11 points, 11 rebounds for West Virginia. Henderson with 14 on 4 of 8 shooting.
Well, Missoula, of course, the story of this game. Duke's going to go home. Valiant effort by this team. West Virginia played superbly in the second half. They were down, and they came back with a vengeance.
Missoula kicks it out to Alexander. 1 minute left. Down low, Missoula is wrapped up by Paulus. Oh, and the crowd now on their feet. The upset has happened here in Washington. West Virginia, the seventh seed, will move on. Duke will, as you mentioned, Bob, go home. And you have to wonder what the skeptics, the critics will have to say about Duke in this program. Had a tough go with Belmont, nearly knocked out Thursday night, and then just had a real collapse here in the second half. Three-point shots did not drop for the Blue Devils.
Well, we know that the Blue Devils are not a big team, and three-point shooting became their signature in their offense this year, and they did not have it in their last three games, and as a result, they've struggled. But I'll tell you what, West Virginia played great. Duke's defense was superb in the first half, holding West Virginia down, but they responded at halftime and came out and played great in the second half.
A late three and a timeout. Paulus dropped it deep. We'll be back. 55 seconds to play. You just joined us. Duke with a five-point lead at the break, 35-29. Looked to have all things cured from Belmont's scare on Thursday night. Second half, all trouble. And now Duke will be forced to foul. They're going to put Alexander at the line.
Bob Huggins takes over in his hometown of West Virginia. Born and raised a Mountaineer. Back coaching his alma mater, where he was a great player. 1977 grad. A great history of success at Cincinnati especially, but also came through the ranks at Akron and took over a program that had been to the Elite Eight and the Sweet 16 in two out of the last 3 years, came in and changed their style, kept what was good from the B-line philosophy, which is the three-point shooting, instituted his very tough man-to-man defense, and it was apparent in the second half here. What a wonderful job he's done of coaching this team.
Yeah, 27 wins a year ago under John Beilein, NIT champions. And West Virginia on their way to their 26th victory of the season. By the way, Huggins just joined that 600 win club this year as well, as Henderson tries to power up and in two.
That's a lot of wins for anybody at any level. And he's done it at places that weren't necessarily great basketball places before he got there. The Duke team is going to leave. Mr. Huggins has punched their ticket. The three-point shooting has evaporated with them in their last three games. And as a result, they're going home early.
Two bounces and down, Henderson. As you look at his numbers career during the tournament, Bob, these are eliminations. Three times out in the first round, eight times out in the second, but not today.
And one time to the Final Four. Six coaches in the Big East Conference have taken teams to the Final Four. That's quite a record. Johnny West, the son of the famed Jerry West. One of the greats in Mountaineer history and NBA history in the game.
Now there's been some great players. Alexander for one, Jerry West. Don't forget Hot Rod Hundley, former first round draft pick out of West Virginia. And the Mountaineers continue to power in. Ruoff, what a game. 16 points for the junior guard out of Spring Hill, Florida. Bob, boy, you got to wonder what's happening in Morgantown as this Mountaineer team is headed to Phoenix.
You think there's a little celebration going on in Morgantown? Take me home, country roads, baby. They're on their way to Phoenix.
And the eyes of Duke. Bob, you worked so hard for so long, and only one team, that's what's tough, only one team walks off the floor the champion.
Every other team in college basketball would end their season with a loss other than the NCAA champions and the NIT champions. Duke had a terrific season.
17-point game for Ruoff. Inside, Paula still working hard. Russell's up two. Henderson takes a seat on the floor. And it has been rough from the start. And that's an understatement.
Desire leads to intensity. Intensity leads to physical play.
Bob, you look ahead. West Virginia will come in with confidence. The Arizona win by 10. And now you walk in and say, we just knocked off the two-seed Duke.
Yeah, well, they're going to have to play either Xavier or Purdue, which are two confident teams as well. And we're going to see them here momentarily.
Hitters and two more. And time running out on Duke. West Virginia, Phoenix, here they come. '73-67, a dominating second half by the Mountaineers of West Virginia. On to the Sweet 16. Our final score, West Virginia 73, Duke 67. Let's send you now to Greg Gumbel in New York.
What an impressive performance by the seventh seed Mountaineers, who move on and they eliminate number two seed Duke 73.